clickbait, so let's stop on welcome clickbait.
Hello, we are Clickbait, RIT's newest improv quasi people. And we're not actually Clickbait and representative of Clickbait, we're Click or Bait or some random amalgamation of other letters in Clickbait, so like half the team. I do the scheduling conflicts and other stuff. But anyways, we've got some improv for you, and to start off, we're going to send Ethan out of the room.
See you guys!
Bye!
Alright, so we're going to be playing a game called Good Cop, Bad Cop, or something along those lines. Yeah. It doesn't matter.
Yeah. Anyways, I'm the good cop.
I'm going to be the bad cop.
And we need a suggestion of three separate things from the audience. The first one will be a famous person.
Or character.
Or character, or whatever. The second will be a crime, and the third
will be a location.
Will be a, location.
Yes.
What's it, crime?
So yeah.
I'm liking Barney the Dinosaur.
Okay, and a crime committed by.
You, give us something.
Stealing nachos.
What?
Stealing nachos.
Stealing nachos.
So we got Barney the Dinosaur stealing nachos. Where is he perpetrating this crime?
Disney ocean.
What you?
Disney World.
Disney World. Sure. Let's go with that. I'll go lead our suspect in. You get the interrogation room ready.
How are you guys doing tonight? Woo! Hey, normally we would just call him in. It's a little suspect that David's going out there, but he's leading in the suspect. Here we go.
Having a bit of a rough day, haven't you?
I guess you could say that.
I brought some Skittles. Do you like some Skittles?
I don't know how you expect me to grab that. A little cuffed up.
Fine, I'll uncuff you for a little bit. Figure I'll make you comfortable.
Man, I'm glad that you trust me.
Well, let's say I've trusted you since I was a small child.
A lot of people have.
And I never trusted this dumb bitch.
Oh, hold up. Let me eat some Skittles first there.
I'm trusting with the Skittles.
You trust him with the Skittles?
No.
I mean, yeah, you figure he was obviously had some blood sugar or something. He had to eat something, obviously.
Yeah.
There's no, like, needed the snack. Gotta help him out. Come on, Rick. You know that, like, you get a little bit sweaty in there.
You can.
I think that it's okay to let him eat a little bit. Mm-hmm. Just a little bit. Okay. So, we just need a confession from you. And,
Confession?
Yeah.
I didn't do anything.
You didn't do anything?
Didn't do anything.
You didn't. What? Look, we know goddamn well that you were at the scene of the crime and nobody else was. Look at this cheese on your paws right now. Come on.
Yeah, there's cheese everywhere. There's cheese everywhere, huh?
I don't know what you want me to say. Huh?
I want you to confess!
What are you trying to make me confess? I plead the fifth. I'm not going to incriminate myself.
You are going to incriminate yourself. You're going to fill in every single blank on this confession sheet, all right? Every single one. You can write, can't you?
Look,
maybe.
No, I'm trying to get this guy to sing, all right?
All right.
Look, Rick, I don't know if he's going to sing if he's not talking about cleaning up.
God.
Do you have any gumdrops?
Gumdrops?
Yeah.
I don't have any gumdrops on me. Should I go get some? Fashion stand? They have a bunch of mouse-shaped ones.
I know. Screw the gumdrops.
It costs way too much anyways.
Look, it's not easy being a mascot.
Well, it's not so much being a mascot as what you represented to me, man.
I loved you.
I loved you.
You love me too. You just messed it up. You made everything. You made my life worse by doing this.
Honestly,
it
sucks.
I did love you.
Yeah.
That's what Barney's speak about.
Yeah.
It's tough to see your heroes die. Some say that.
Well, why am I even here? You don't have anything on me. Not a single thing.
Well, you have,
anything on you?
What's this, huh? What's that? You want to answer me for that?
I don't know, man.
Cheesy.
Huh? Can you taste it?
Nah.
Can I ring your memory?
Nah.
A little bit? No? Okay. It's fine.
Rick, make him taste it.
What? You can't do that.
All right.
You can't make me taste it.
Oh, we'll make you taste it.
No, no, don't. Don't. No. No. No.
You're not resisting.
No.
You're
stop
not
it.
Resisting.
Obviously couldn't resist it earlier.
You couldn't resist it earlier. You licked it all up.
Jesus. Crunch. Look, I get it. Like, they're really expensive. Little mouse-shaped tortilla chips. They're cute as hell. You know how much we pay for those? A lot. They're custom-made by little Chinese workers. And let me tell you,
I told you, I love kids. I was just trying to promote those sweatshops, and I just got out of hand.
Hey, you know what? You know what? You weren't promoting those sweatshops. You were working those kids out of a job. You didn't work either.
They're not out of a job. I mean,
consumption has gone up.
That is true. Sorry I ate all the cheese.
Well,
you don't just eat cheese, right?
You put them on, man.
God. You see this?
Yeah.
There isn't just cheese on this.
See those little fucking crumbs on there?
And the crackers, I'm sorry!
This guy.
I mean, there's melted cheese everywhere. There's a child crying. And I'm afraid we're gonna have to string you up for this one.
Like, hang me?
No. God, no. We're not even authorized to do that here.
Don't tell him that. Don't tell him that. I want him to squirm. I want him to just...
Sorry,
dude,
all the
we
nachos.
Can only keep him here. Yeah. Good. You write that on the confession sheet?
Yeah. How can you even prove this? Like,
we have
there
cameras
was no scene at
everywhere.
We have cameras.
There are cameras on every surface, and we watch every one of our guests here.
We have players everywhere, too.
We do. And not the kind you're thinking of.
You know, all the kids there saw you too.
Yeah.
There's so many witnesses.
Right outside the teacups. It's where you can probably hear. It's a small world in the background.
I wasn't at Disney World.
Yeah, you were. You're freaking in jail right now.
He confessed.
You're really gonna take me to jail? Me, Barney the Dinosaur, for eating nachos, all of the nachos at Disneyland.
We're gonna keep you in jail.
You should put up a sign saying that you can't do that, sir.
We're gonna keep you in the house of jail for at least another 55 minutes. Alright. Yes, sir. Excellent. So next up, we're gonna run an ASCAT.
Woo!
And anyways, to start that off, I need a suggestion. Let's go with something that you ate today that you liked.
Yellowfin tuna.
Yellowfin tuna.
I heard black tar heroin.
Why not? Okay, so you said black tar heroin. And that reminds me of way back in the day when I got out of my first relationship and into Tinder for the first time. And oh, the places it'll take you. I went out on like 12 to 15 Tinder dates, super freaking thirsty, 18, 19 year old in college, you know. And one of those Tinder dates, I met a wonderful girl named Colette. I don't think I need to protect her name, right? Should I call her something else? I don't know. She's a working woman down in Rochester and living nightlife as it was. And so after a long day of partying or whatever, she invited me out to an after party. And I get to the party and everybody's dancing. And I am super hyped because I like to dance. Like, that's pretty much all I like to do when I go out and party is just dance and like drink. Because everything else is kind of worthless. So I probably like 10 or 12 people at this party. Really small, I was surprised, like walking in, like just hearing the music bumping really loud. And people were this really small crowd. I was expecting a huge crowd. Eventually the music like kind of wound down or found a low spot and they pulled out needles and they shot some heroin, which I was really surprised about because I did not expect that at all. I wonder if it was even heroin. They offered me some, and I asked for a beer because I'm not trying to get that deep into a Tinder date, really. I met her for coffee a few times, and then finding out her friends shoot something. Thinking about it, there was a lot of dancing, and from Breaking Bad, I'm pretty sure it's more of a knockout drug. But that being said, they were putting something in their arms and scared the absolute shit out of me. And that's the story.
Right swipe.
You right swipe on that?
I right swipe on them all, man.
I can tell, dude. Maybe you should stop casting that net out so far. Look, I'm pretty good at Tinder. Like, let me look at your profile. Ooh, the dog's good. Dog's great. Ladies love a dog.
I like 3 pictures of dog.
Yeah. Your dog might be better next time. I mean, like, Peppers is great, and I've loved her for a long time, but, like, maybe get your own dog and post that. Just a suggestion. Maybe for a second date, show them your dog.
Well, yeah. First I have to get the first date, okay?
Okay, that's fair. Let's start there. I
gotta tell you something, though. I actually got a match the other day.
You got a match?
Yeah. After 3 years of swiping right.
Years?
Yeah. Swiping right?
You know that you have to have pictures of yourself on there too, right? You got 3 pictures of my dog. You have a picture of an American flag and a picture of a truck.
Yeah. Don't forget about the hunting rifles.
Well, yeah, I leaned up against the truck, but like, how is anybody gonna know what you look like, dude?
They don't really need to know. They know everything they know everything about me already.
I mean, I guess, but I mean, are you really looking for somebody to look at your personality? I mean, like, all right, dude.
You know, I want a girl to love me for my personality. I want a girl to love me for my looks, all right? Because, let's face it, you're Billy Bob.
I'm Billy Bob.
Are you Galactica?
That is my street name. Do you have the $200?
Oh, this costs money.
Yeah, I thought I clearly hinted at, you know, pay for service and wasn't talking about no payphone. Listen, tell you what, $200 up front, I'll love your personality too.
You know what? I appreciate that.
Wait up, dude.
Riot?
Riot, look at her.
That, is she a hooker? I'm pretty sure she's a hooker, dude.
She turned out to be a hooker, but you know what?
At least you know what you got.
I didn't think you'd be coming in right now. I mean, come on, I texted you, told you I needed the room.
You didn't tell me hard enough.
I can't think of any way else to tell you.
Billy? Is this your roommate you told me about?
Yeah.
Elisha on the floor.
I thought so too, but you know.
Can you take my restraints off, Billy?
Oh, you guys are
Yeah, that's yeah.
All right.
Sexy lingerie.
Yeah.
The ropes.
Okay.
That's
get it.
Why I have this pot and ball gag. I was gonna smoke her up and then woo.
Well, like that's what I came in here to tell you about, Billy.
What?
I can't let you smoke anything up anymore because you haven't paid rent. All right.
Billy.
Is this really the appropriate time to be talking about this? I'm literally in the middle of something.
You know what? She can stay here. She can help me pay rent.
Do you think I have a job?
I thought this was your job. Me.
Whoa.
What?
Jackson don't...
You can't pay rent.
Jackson don't pay no hookers if you can't pay rent. You see?
That's flawless logic right there.
I know.
What did you just call me, Billy?
I said you weren't a hooker.
Good shit.
All right, I admit it. I have a Miss Jackson fetish.
Now,
I'll
tell you what. I'm gonna give you a couple minutes to gather your thoughts. I'm gonna give you a couple minutes to gather your feelings, all right?
Mm-hmm. So, to be clear, you're gonna let me fuck her, right?
I think we have to have a discussion about that, Billy.
Oh man, you look pretty spiffy.
Yeah, got the new tracksuit on.
Oh yeah?
Oh yeah,
dude,
I'm ready.
The ladies love a tracksuit.
Yeah, well, you know. I figure I need to stop thinking about the women and really focus on my goals.
Mm-hmm. Did you get the tracksuit from my friend Vlad?
I did not actually get it from
you
Vlad.
Didn't.
This is brand new. I know it looks just like his, but like, you see that emblem? Mm-hmm. That's actually a Nike logo, not the reverse one that Vlad has.
Oh,
man. Vlad's a great guy, but he buys a lot of knockoffs, man. Just saying. You interested in running? Running with me today?
I mean,
you're gonna be a bitch again, huh?
Look, I can't run.
You can't run?
I can't run.
That sounds like a lame excuse.
Yeah. I have orthopedic legs. They were specially designed to release the stress within my lower region by removing it.
Well, what is your name once again?
My name is Bill.
Bill, okay. Mm-hmm. So I designed these orthopedic legs for you to be able to help you run better again.
Yes, I understand that, Vlad. Mm-hmm. As my closest friend and Russian surgeon, I really appreciate this. You know, I couldn't have gotten these legs on U.S. soil. These are nice red legs.
It's not very red.
Yes.
So I have a question.
What is it, Vlad?
I saw you talking earlier to a guy who is wearing something little like this.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's my roommate.
That's your roommate?
Yeah, Sven.
That's Sven?
That's Sven.
I don't like Sven.
Sven? No, it's Sven. Sven.
One word.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. He changed his name. You know, he wanted to sound more Russian, but I don't know.
You know what? Sven is a Swedish name.
Is it?
That's the first problem.
Wow.
He's trying to wear my clothes and now he's,
So, you got those orthopedic legs from your friend, Vlad, right?
Yeah, Sven. Yeah, I did.
I, gotta tell you, I don't like that guy.
Oh, happy coincidence. He doesn't like you either.
What, does he have no reason to...
He has no reason. Well, that's absolute... Mm.
You see, Vlad says... you know, Vlad's Russian, right?
Yeah.
He said Sven wasn't a Russian name. It was actually Swedish. And he thinks you're just a poser. He thinks you're trying to copy him. Well, why are you in medical school right now?
Look, all right. First of all, Vlad is not a real surgeon. I don't know why you let him cut off your legs. Second of all, he's calling me a poser. He doesn't have a real Nike tracksuit.
I mean, that's kind of the whole point. You know, not capitalists and not consuming. It's his own off-brand.
He came up with that?
He did come up with that.
That's a V, not a Nike symbol?
Yeah, it's a V. It's a very weird thing.
That makes a lot of sense, actually.
Mm-hmm.
He sewed that himself?
So you're Sven.
Da. Da.
I gotta tell you something. I do not like you.
You don't... Alright, look, I was just about to form some respect for you. Look, Vlad, with a V... I really think that maybe we could, I don't know, have some respect for each other instead.
I respect you, I just do not like you. That's possible, you know.
Is it? I hadn't thought of anything other than respect. I can't think of anyone I like.
What's your friend Billy?
Do you Billy? No, that guy's a bitch, dude. You won't hurt me. It's awful.
You know what?
Did you run? Are those real legs?
No, they're actually Billy's legs.
They're pretty muscular calves there. You made a good choice.
I made a very good choice.
Yeah.
And that's our show!